Well, my name is Patrick Mbama. I work with Milele College as the deputy principal, in charge of curriculum development. And I also volunteer with St. John Ambulance, Kenya, Rift Valley region, as a first aid trainer.
Did you have any real experience where your first aid skills saved someone?
Well, last year, a young girl suddenly fell dizzy in our church, and with another person's help within the church, the girl was brought to a quiet place. We helped the girl come to a quiet place. We assessed her as pertaining to her condition. Later on, she fainted due to low sugar levels in her body. And we asked her if she had any other medical history. Afterwards, I helped elevating her legs to promote blood circulation, and she recovered soon after. We gave her some sweet drink, actually gave her some Fanta soda, and she became much better. When she later saw a doctor, the doctor concurred with everything that we did, and the doctor actually confessed that the girl had fainted, and what we did was actually correct. A few years ago, I can't remember, that a friend of mine, who was a fellow instructor in one of the trainings that we do, was breathless and perspiring actually at the office. I told him that he may be having a heart attack, so I, without delay, another colleague and I brought him to the nearest clinic. Of course, he collapsed before that is on reaching the clinic, and the doctor attended to him quickly. After calling St. John Ambulance, he was rushed to the nearest hospital, that is PGH, and since then he recovered. I felt really good.
Why is first aid important?
Now, good question. We cannot actually predict when an emergency may occur or when someone becomes sick suddenly. And it would be quite heart-wrenching if that person is a family member and you are not able to help because you do not have first aid knowledge.
What is the first thing you say to those who attend the first aid class?
Well, I would congratulate them. That is the first thing that I do. As they are doing their family a very huge favor by learning first aid. And by learning first aid skills, they would really be doing their family a great favor. To such people, I would also encourage to share what they learn with friends and their colleagues. Very important.
How many classes do you have to attend to be first aid certified?
That depends, actually. If you're just learning for your personal reasons, that is, if you're learning first aid for your personal reasons, then usually the standard first aid training that takes 3 days would be really adequate. But we should emphasize on the fact that frequent exposures to first aid trainings can eventually amount to real skill in first aid, and that would really widen your knowledge and experience in as far as first aid is concerned.
What's your message to those without first aid training?
The message is clear, that be prepared, learn first aid. It's like actually buying an insurance policy. Just in case you need to use it, you can use it whenever you want to use it. Your family actually will be the major beneficiary of your first aid training.
Can you share with us a crucial first aid tip that not many are aware of?
Yeah, probably I can share something. And in any medical emergency, you have to be very careful about their surroundings, That is your surrounding as the first aid, as the first aider, and the surroundings of the casualties and also the bystanders, the people that come around during first aid emergencies. For example, if it's a road traffic accident, the danger in helping casualties will be the oncoming traffic. Therefore, you have to survey the scene for any potential danger. Because the worst thing that we shall do in any scene of emergency is actually to put the first aider in danger. If we lose the first aider, then there is nothing much that we are doing as first responders.
What are you doing to ensure that such skills are obtained by all people?
Well, that's not easy, especially with the current generation that appears to be a bit busy. But as a college, what we've agreed to do is to give back to the community. And to start us off, during the holiday, the April holiday 2019, we want to reach out to churches that are within Nakuru and its neighborhood, and we want to provide free first aid training to the youth within the church. Our vision is that by 2030, every household will actually have a first aider. And we think and we hope that by reaching out to churches, we shall be able to get to the targeted single first aider in every household. So we are providing an opportunity to to the pastors of churches within Nakuru County to convene their youth and notify us in a week's time that we may come present ourselves with a team that will be training on first aid freely as a college, because we think that that is a call that we've been called to attend to in our service to humanity.
Thank you, Mr. Boma.
You're most welcome.